Are you a new or aspiring game dev who just happens to also love retro gaming? You're not alone. There are so many tools for game development right now. Where do you even begin? It can be overwhelming, even more so if you're just starting your game dev career. Well, if you're a fan of retro-inspired pixel art games and long for the days of sharing cartridges with buddies, we have an awesome tool to share with you. We are talking about PICO-8, the fantasy game console and game engine created by Lexa Lawful Games. PICO-8 was created to virtually mimic a typical 1980s video game console in all of its capabilities and limitations. In technical terms, this means a 128 by 128 pixel display with a whopping fixed 16 color palette and 4-channel sound output with 64 definable sound slots. Aside from all these nostalgic limitations, though, what makes PICO-8 stand out from a typical retro game console? Well, imagine turning on your console and having it greet you with a fully-fledged Lua-based game development suite. And this is just the tip of the iceberg. Let's dive into it. Please note, this isn't a sponsored video. We're just enamored with the PICO-8 console/engine and community, and we wanted to share why.
We are Ask Gamedev,
and these are 8 reasons we
love PICO-8. Welcome back. We make videos on how to elevate your game development and inspire others. If after watching this video, you want to continue the game dev conversation, check the video description for a link to our Discord server. We are now making fresh Ask Gamedev content on all of the major social networks, so be sure to check us out there too. Number 1. It has a full, built-in suite of game development tools. As we mentioned earlier, we love PICO-8 because the moment you run it, a screen greets you with the option to run a cartridge or enter the editor. This editor is a PICO-8 game development suite consisting of a Lua-based code editor where you can see and edit the source code of any PICO-8 game, or write your code from scratch with a maximum of 8,192 tokens of code. A sprite editor where you can draw and edit a maximum of 256 8x8 pixel sprites using a fixed 16 color palette. A map editor where you can place all the sprites and build your game visually. And a sound editor consisting of 64 definable chip blurps which can be later mixed in a 4-channel pattern compositor to produce the most catchy, groovy, cool, gloomy, dark, or awesome chip tunes you can imagine. After your game is complete, it is saved and exported as a PNG image of a cartridge. Yes, all the game is fitted into a single PNG image, which can either be sent to anyone that has access to PICO-8 or upload it to the PICO-8 library. Nothing else is required to play the game but that single PNG cartridge. Number 2. PICO-8 is a great way for beginners to learn game dev. As we just saw, this fantasy console comes with a complete and easy-to-use development suite. New developers may find themselves in a good spot when grabbing PICO-8 as their training sanctuary. The creative tools are very intuitive and give the developer a lot of space for imagination. The code editor also comes with 2 big advantages. For starters, it uses Lua, a scripting language known for having a fast learning curve and great versatility. Also, you can inspect the code of any game you're playing in PICO-8 by pressing the Escape key. This will pause the game and take you straight to the console's code editor where you can inspect the code, learn from it, change it in any way you want, and also access the game through the other creation tools. If that's not enough, you can also head to the Resources tab on the PICO-8 website and take a look through the documentation that the team has made to ease you into the wonderful development world of PICO-8. After you've exported a game that you want to share, you can submit it to the console's online library. This takes us to number 3. There are so many awesome, original PICO-8 games. When you turn on PICO-8, you can type Splore. This command will take you to a built-in gallery called Splore, where you can see all the games that have been submitted by the devs in the community. You can update it constantly and save the games you like to play them offline, mod them, or tinker with them in any way you want. You can also find the PICO-8 Cartverse on Lexa Lawful's website, where you can play PICO-8 titles directly in browser without having to download any plugin. PICO-8 games can even be exported for the web and published on sites like itch.io. PICO-8 games are drawing the attention of creative developers that are constantly pushing the limits of what this simple engine can do. Some amazing examples we've come across include Celeste Classic by Noel Berry and Maddie Thorson. Yes, the hugely popular game Celeste was originally conceived in PICO-8. Celeste Classic was created during a four-day game jam. Recently, devs at XOK Games published a PICO-8 sequel called Celeste Classic 2 to celebrate the game's third anniversary. Alfonso's Bowling Challenge by Kitten Master, an apparent bowling game that quickly escalates into definitely something else. Mott's 8-Ball Pool by Tom Mulgrew, a 3D pool game. Orbeez by Pod, another game that showcases the 3D capabilities of PICO-8. Dank Tomb by Jacob Wasilewski, a fantastically lit retro puzzle adventure game about exploring caves and uncovering the story of a mad king. Number 4, there are also so many awesome PICO-8 Dmakes. Within the cartverse, many famous Dmakes have been conceived. A Dmake is a minimalistic remake of a game. It's accomplished by recreating the game in an older or more limited platform than the original. The game development tools of PICO-8 make it a perfect place for creating and playing awesome Dmakes like PICO Fox by Electric Griffin, an amazing 3D Star Fox Dmake that features the core loop we all know from Star Fox games. Delunky by Johan P. Spelunk your way through this addictive mini version of Derek Yu's Spelunky. Low Mem Sky by Liquid Dream, a Dmake for No Man's Sky that doesn't fall short of the original, featuring around 180 billion unique star systems to visit. PicoHot, created by Piotr Kola, Wojciech Zidzik, and Marius Tarkowski, who all worked on the official SuperHot. This Dmake was born when they were trying to find an idea to fit SuperHot onto a floppy disk. Well, now it fits in a PNG. And of course, we can find all-time classics like Wolfenstein's Dmake by Hungry Butterfly, and a mind-blowing PICO-8 version of Doom titled Poom and recreated by Fred72. Number 5. There is a thriving PICO-8 community. For those who've just discovered PICO-8, or even those who are new to game development overall, there are several YouTube channels packed with tutorials about everything you need to know to get started. Some of these are Nerdy Teachers, a channel fully dedicated to PICO-8 basics, the best place to start your path. Lazy Devs, where you can find incredible tricks like enabling 32 colors in PICO-8, or even learn how to set up a physical PICO-8 handheld console using a Raspberry Pi. And Gruber, a musician and sound designer that makes tutorials about music and sound design in the PICO-8 engine. Lexalawful also hosts a bustling forum where devs gather and share all kinds of discoveries, mods, and feats. For example, a lot of users love to mod Celeste Classic, spawning a whole library just with this trend. There's even a dev, shout out to Juan Galvan, that came up with a port to play Celeste Classic on Android. Another dev, Johan Pietz, developed a tool called PicoCAD, a program to design and texture low-poly 3D models. You can find the tool at itch.io. For more on the PICO-8 community, you can follow trends and conversations on Twitter by following the PICO-8 hashtag. And you can also join the PICO-8 subreddit at r/PICO8. Number 6. It's an awesome tool for a game jam. PICO-8 lets you build an idea from the ground up in a matter of hours. With Lua and the creative tools in the engine, you can build a quick prototype and polish it enough to have one of the best game jam entries you could achieve in a relatively short amount of time. There are several game jams that gather PICO-8 developers, like the Fantasy Console Game Jam, where participants have 1 week to make a game using the fantasy console of their liking. 1 hour Game Jam, a game jam that happens every Saturday. Dmake Jam, a game jam that has spawned some of the Dmakes we already mentioned. Even the Global Game Jam is receiving PICO-8 entries. Additionally, Luxalawful Games has hosted the P8 Jam, a game jam for the PICO-8 community. Winning games of this game jam include Frog Home by JTE and Combo Pool by Newsan. Number 7. You can play PICO-8 games on the go. Thanks to several members of the PICO-8 community that have put their efforts into searching for and even building the best handheld consoles to run PICO-8, finding a portable solution for running PICO-8 titles is easy. First, there's Clockwork Pi Game Shell, a modular open-source handheld device that features a custom 1 GHz quad-core CPU, 1 GB of DDR3 memory, and full Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and HDMI connectivity. Powered by a Linux-based custom OS, it can run the official PICO-8 release and all of its games. As for its performance playing PICO-8 games, LazyDev's YouTube channel calls it spectacular. Next, we have the family of Anbernic handheld devices. Although they don't natively support the PICO-8 app, they have received attention from the community. A PICO-8 community member has even developed an emulator that can smoothly run PICO-8 carts on Anbernic devices. The community has two favorite Anbernic handhelds: the RG280V, a miniature console with a neat 2.8-inch IPS display, and the RG350, a bigger, more functional handheld with two sticks, a D-pad, and 10 buttons. Another great handheld is the Pocket Chip. The Pocket Chip is specially made not just to play games, but to edit them or even create them. This is why it features a built-in keyboard from which you can access and use the PICO-8 development suite. At launch, PICO-8 was pre-installed in the Pocket Chip, finally bringing the fantasy console into reality. Our eighth and final reason to love PICO-8 is that it has easy and clever ways to share your work. As we mentioned previously, a PICO-8 cartridge consists of a special PNG image and nothing else. This file can be sent to others by any means. Amazing as it is, it's not the only way developers are sharing their work in PICO-8. As an example, there are tweet carts. Tweet carts are tweets containing the whole code of a game or animation made in PICO-8. All you have to do is copy the text in the tweet and paste it to your PICO-8 code editor. These tweets are usually paired with a GIF, or GIF if you prefer, showing what the code produces. Search for the hashtag tweetcart on Twitter to find some amazing examples. PICO-8 also makes capturing GIFs extra easy. All you have to do is press F9 at any moment to capture and export the last 8 seconds of gameplay as a GIF. Lastly, PICO-8 also lets you export your game to standalone HTML5, Windows, Mac, and Linux executables, letting you distribute your game pretty much in any way that you want to. If you want to share a PICO-8 game cartridge with the Ask Gamedev community, you can do it through our Discord server. We'll leave a link in the description of this video. Hope to see you there. Thanks for watching. For more Ask Gamedev, check out this playlist of game engine showcases or this video featuring amazing solo developed titles.